an independent analyst. He has been opposed to the prosecution's move in recent weeks to present evidence to prove something not alleged in the impeachment complaint. Attorney Mac, good morning.
Hey, good morning,
good to see you.
Maraming salamat.
Okay, ang dami nating pag-uusapan, Attorney Romy Mac. First is, I guess I want to ask you, Senate, have they actually pinned down so far? You've been watching every day. Have they pinned down the Chief Justice in Article 2?
Well, they have presented documentary evidence, but until now, the so-called smoking gun has not yet been presented by the prosecution's panel, with due respect. But we expect them to present evidence to prove that there was really something wrong in the sal end of the Chief Justice. But the problem is, while they were able to present some documentary evidence to prove that there were something missing in the items present in the sal end of the Chief Justice, the issue now is whether or not the missing items could constitute violation or culpable violation of the Constitution, or is this really a case of betrayal of public trust? Because nobody knows how to present, how to make a perfect sal end.
That's exactly what I wanted to ask you.
I don't
know. How is that supposed to be done?
Well, nobody has seen a sal end, ano?
I've seen it recently because of the impeachment trial.
Case, yeah. I have not seen the sal end of the Chief Justice. I'm not very familiar in the preparation of sal end because I'm not a government employee. But perhaps the best evidence to show a correct sal end might depend upon the prosecution. Because if I were the prosecution, I will present a good example of a correct sal end. I will tell the impeachment court that ito po ang tamang sal end. Katunayan, ito po ang aking isinabmit na sal end. So this is the correct sal end, and I want to compare this sal end with the sal end of the Chief Justice.
But what is in the law? Because what I understand, at least from the days of trial, is that are you really supposed to fill up every single column there? Number one, sir, that's my first question. And kasi yung hindi nila na fill up yung acquisition
cost. Well, the fact that these items are there is supposed to be filled up. But then, the civil service rules and even the 6713 is not very specific as to the obligation of a party in the event that he fails to fill it up.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, the rule is that the reviewing committee in charge with the salary of a particular employee has to refer this back to the employee and require the employee to correct. Whatever defects there is in the salary.
To be very specific about it, what you're saying is someone like Chief Justice Renato Corona submits that to the clerk of court.
Mm-hmm.
And the clerk of court realizes there seems to be something wrong with this. The clerk of court, kailan ibalik yan kay Chief
Hindi
Justice?
Hindi lang clerk of court, kundi because there is a reviewing committee.
Pero submitted sa clerk of court,
submitted sa clerk of court.
Who is the reviewing committee at the Supreme
I don't know
court?
In the Supreme Court who is the reviewing committee, but of course the Chief Justice has something to do with it. And he has to organize or create a committee that will review all this all.
So that means there's liability in the reviewing committee because may responsibility in reviewing committee. Ibalik sa'yo yon if there seems to be something wrong with it.
Dapat ganun. But then the problem is, sinong reviewing committee gumagawa nito? I have not heard of any reviewing committee that has complied with this obligation. But after all is said and done in this case, whether a documentary evidence or testimonial evidence has been presented, you know, the issue here is not the evidence, but the standard of proof that might be the basis of a central judge to convict or to acquit the accused.
Let's talk about that very briefly, Attorney Romy Mac, because that was brought up by Senator Judge Miriam Defensor Santiago during one of the hearings. And she said, what kind of standard evidence are we looking at?
Mm.
The prosecution says
substantial evidence.
Substantial.
Or preponderance of evidence.
Ang sabi ni Senator Miriam, preponderance of evidence.
Preponderance of evidence. Sabi
and
naman ng defense,
proof
beyond reasonable doubt.
What is the standard of evidence?
Wala. There is no standard standard of evidence, standard of proof. There's a difference between evidence and proof. The standard of proof in a criminal case is proof beyond reasonable doubt. In civil case, it is preponderance of evidence. But in impeachment court, there is no standard of proof required, nor is there any standard of proof defined under the Constitution. It will always be the product of the minds of the senator judges. Sabi nga the senator, and really, it is the product of my own mind.
Mm.
Kasi senador ang magdi-decide yan eh. The senator is not required to explain his vote. The senator is not required to write down the basis of his decision. At the end of the day, on judgment day, the senator would only be asked, what is your verdict? Is it guilty or not? Is he guilty or not guilty? tatayo lang yung senator, guilty or not guilty. Mamimili siya, choose the best answer lang. Hindi tatanungin, anong basis mo? Yung ba ay because of some substantial evidence or because of reasonable doubt? Hindi siya sasagot doon. Kahit sabihin niya, sabi ng kapitbahay ko, ganun eh. So, walang standard of proof dito. Ito ngayon ang napakahirap dito sa impeachment trial na ito. We have been talking of many, many kinds of evidence, but then, at the end of the day, the problem is, what is the standard of proof required? It will depend on the senator judge. Hindi siya mananagot kahit kanino. He will only be answerable to the people on election day.
Right. So, even if the senators, I understand, Attorney Mac, they're supposed to take this up in a caucus.
Mm-hmm.
Isa yan sa mga nabitin, yeah. Ano? Yung standard of proof pala.
Yes.
You call it standard of proof. I thought it was standard of evidence. Standard of proof. At the end of the day, even if, for example, say they say, at the worst, proof beyond reasonable doubt, or at best for the Chief mm-hmm. Justice, proof yeah. beyond reasonable doubt. If I'm a senator judge, it's still up to me.
Yeah, it's up to you. Sabihin mo na, sa akin tingin, proof beyond reasonable doubt na yan eh. But then, as tulad sinabi ko, he will never be asked to explain.
Yeah.
He will never be asked to write down, put it in writing. Ano, ha? Basta pagdating doon, guilty po yan. O not guilty po ang aking verdict.
Okay.
So, ganun lang ang gagawin nila.
Alright, so I guess, sir, no matter what they agree on, on what standard of proof is it doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter. No? Sa akin, ganun, ano, with due respect to the impeachment court. Pero dito siguro, dapat bilisan nila. No, ha? Kasi kawawa naman taong bayan. I would always suggest to the prosecution that if you believe that you have already hit your target insofar as Article 2 is concerned, then move on to another article.
But it doesn't look like you think that they reached their target.
Yes, sa ngayon, wala pa eh. But insofar as the prosecution is concerned, they have been telling everybody that meron na kaming ebidensya.
Okay, balikan natin yung ebidensya very quickly, sir, because Senator Judge Jinggoy Estrada was saying, how many articles have you, how many properties have you actually proven here? To cut this conversation from 45, they said it's 21.
Yeah, 21.
Did you see 21? Did you
I think 21? mga 24, including the parking lots.
Including the parking lots. Pero yun din ang bilang mo, sir.
Pero alam mo yan, hindi naman yan sa dami ng, yung dami ng properties. It's not the number of properties, but the strength of the evidence against the Chief Justice that will matter.
Mm.
Kahit na lang ba isang property lang yan, if the prosecution could prove that this property was acquired by the Chief Justice disproportionate to his income as a Chief Justice or as a Justice of the Supreme Court, liable na rin siya doon. Ano, hindi naman kailangan pang lahat ng properties yung 45 ipag-usapan. Kahit isa lamang po pwede
na
yun.
Sana hindi na nila sinasama yung mga parking slot para hindi nila magulo eh.
Hindi na dapat isinasama yung sa mga anak. Ano, hindi na dapat isinasama yung sa mga anak.
Hindi, kasi they were trying... They were, di ba? It's obvious, sir, what they were trying to do. They're trying to prove that ginagawang dami yung
dami,
mga anak.
Pero they have to prove na talagang dami lang yun because it, as it turned out now, sinasabi nga ng depensa, maganda naman pala yung hanap buhay ng anak na yun. Ano? Professional na doctor of medicine yata yung kanyang...
PT ata in the
yes,
States.
Oh,
very
States.
Successful
practitioner. Kaya mahirap din na...
But then, remember, sir, sinabi din nila that... not the exact words, but I think it was Congressman Kimbo who was saying, okay, kundi 45-21, are we saying okay ang 21? Di ba may, parang may ganun.
Hindi nga sinasabi ko, kahit na ba hindi 45, kahit isa lang eh. Ay kung talagang malakas ang kailang ebidensya. Siguro ganun. Kaya lang ang dapat siguro gawin ng prosecution, mas mabilis ang kanilang trial process. Hindi yung, you know, they have already agreed before the trial. This would be the evidence that we are going to present. Mm-hmm. They have xeroxed the document. And they xeroxed the document and marked the documents in the presence of the other party. Dapat noon, before the introduction of the evidence, mag-agree na agad sila na these were really identified by the witness. Instead of still qualifying the witness, are you the register of deeds? How long have you been there? For do you know the ganito?
What is the reason for you coming?
Oh, what is the reason?
Ay, alam mo naman yung impeachment
court. Oh, and how long have you been working? And as a register of deeds, what are your duties and functions? These are not material to the case. And this only gives the other party a chance to question the credibility of the
Even
witness.
Even dissect that witness.
Oh,
huh?
And as a matter of fact, nag-agree na nga kayo. Sinasamantala ngayon ng depensa. And I'm sure the defense is taking advantage of that. Because the defense wants this case to prolong, para yung tao, ma-board na lang yan, mawala ng gana. Then at the end of the day, sasabi na Senator, teka, wala na rin gana ang mga tao rito. Hindi na rin natin mapapakinabangan to.
All right. Dun sa 21 properties though, or 24, Attorney Mac, what do you think of that so far? I mean, balikan natin very briefly, and they're saying, okay, meron yung properties ito, pero belatedly, claim of the prosecution, okay, belatedly nilagay sa SALN, nilagay ng 2010,
na late nga daw, no? Late.
Oo. But, sinabi naman daw dun sa batas na there is a chance for you to actually amend your SALN. So, how are we supposed to understand that?
Well, hanggang ngayon, actually, the parties were asked to submit memorandum on this matter.
Yes.
No? And ako, I don't want to pretend that I know how to answer that. Okay. Pero para sa akin, siyempre, laging papasok dyan yung good faith. Ano, and lagi inaalaw naman, as a matter of fact, the employees are allowed to amend their SALN. Now, if you amend your SALN, does it mean to say that you have already committed something wrong?
Yes.
In the case of the Chief Justice, whether you are a Chief Justice or a janitor, you are entitled to the same law, to the application of the same law. If the janitor is entitled to amend his SALN, and so much so with the Chief Justice. And ngayon, pag inamend mo ba yan, ibig bang sabihin nagkamali ka na o nagkasala ka na? Well, the fact that you are asked to amend means that there is that remedy of amendment.
Okay, so hindi ka pa nagkakasala. Parang gano'n
ang sinasabi mo, sir. Parang hindi pa nagkakasala kasi yun ang batas.
Binibigyan ka ng chance.
Oo, binibigyan ka ng pagkakataon.
Wala, parang walang ano, no, Attorney Mac, walang amended in 2 years. Walang gano'n eh. Tapos open-ended.
Walang gano'n. Basta after the reviewing committee has reviewed the documents, that would be the time when he would advise the other party.
Maybe it's good to find out who the reviewing committee is.
Oh, siguro gano'n ano ha. Pero siguro, siyempre naman, you cannot deny the prosecution that the fact that they were really trying their best, you know, to present evidence to prove that these were violations committed by the Chief Justice in the preparation of his SALN.
Okay.
Ang theory dito ng prosecution is, if the employee fails to fill up properly the SALN, that is already a betrayal of public trust.
Yun ang sinasabi nila. Kasi hindi nilagay yung acquisition cost.
Hindi nilagay yung acquisition cost. Sinasabi niya na parang meron kang inililihim.
Opo,
meron kami tinatago. And that is now one of the issues to be decided.
Pero, ang sinasabi naman ng defense, sandali lang, nilagay ko naman yung assessment at saka yung market value.
Market value. Oh. Pero bakit hindi mo nilagay yung acquisition cost? Yeah. Bakit? Ano-anong dahilan? Ikaw ba'y may itinatago dyan? This is now the reason why the prosecutions and the defense were directed to submit the respective memorandum.
Okay.
Alam mo itong SALN ito, pati yung mga bank accounts na yan, ano, these are really necessary para and the testimony of the BIR para malaman na, okay, nabili mo itong properties na ito and here is the income as testified to by the BIR. While we have not seen dito yung kung there's ill-gotten well or what, this would be now part of the memorandum to support the memorandum of the parties. The prosecutor will now say that on the basis of the SALN and the income as testified to by the BIR, ito ang aming conclusion. So, sa ngayon, wala tayong makikita na talagang evidence to prove na guilty itong si Chief Justice Corona. But the moment na pinagsama-sama itong ebidensya ito ng prosecution, that would be the time when we could make a conclusion. And even the impeachment court could only make a conclusion after all this evidence from the prosecution and the defense had been properly adduced by the parties.
What constitutes an impeachable offense for you, Attorney Mac?
Well, defined naman yan sa ating sa constitution natin. Ano, yung,
hindi, kasi yung betrayal of... I mean, sorry, let me zero in on betrayal of public trust kasi medyo... Wala ata siya talagang definition.
Wala tayong definition dyan. Pati yung culpable violation of the Constitution. Kaya even the parties are also required to submit their memorandum kasi pati yung impeachment court ay hindi na masabi yan. Ano, at kami mga lawyers, siyempre, bago lang na sa amin to, hindi rin kami makapagsabi, ano bang betrayal of public trust?
Ano nga
well,
ba?
Basta nag-violate. Alam mo naman di ba? You know for a fact, your common sense will dictate that there was really a violation.
Yeah, but what constitutes
it should be
it
in a high degree of violation.
That
it really shocks the conscience of an individual. That pag nakita mo lang yun, talagang ikaw, shocking talaga yung evidence na isinasubmit nila.
Oo. With your indulgence, Attorney Mac,